Hello everyone, peace of Christ to all. Before we start this video, I want to inform people that we are now trying to establish a new website, and that website is going to contain my video only in it. The website name is The Deception of Allah. It's exactly the name of my book, because Muslims, they keep flagging my videos in YouTube. We have already a website, it's called Muhammad too, but that website is for everybody to load videos. So people, they get confused where to find my video exactly. So I decided to make a website just only for my videos, and people always, they can go there and they can get their reference and they can refute Muslims, etc. Now, in today's topic, I'm going to compare between two chapters, one from the Bible and one from the Quran. Now, both they present the prayer of Muslims. You know, all of us, we as a Christians, in Arabic we say Aban al-Ladhi, in English people they say our Father out of heaven prayer, right? And this can be found in Matthew chapter 6. Now the Muslim, they have a chapter 1 in the Quran, which is a chapter al-Fatiha. And by the way, this is not the first chapter was given to Muhammad, but Muslims, they play with their Quran and they change location of chapters, and they made the one which given to Muhammad the first to be at the end of the Quran. So now today we find it as chapter 96. So imagine from chapter 1, they move it to 96. And they say that we are the one who corrupted the Bible. But the fact, look, they are even changing the way supposedly the God of Muhammad gave him the Quran. Anyway, in here, you know, we will see the huge difference between Christianity and Islam. It's just in two chapters, and we will show you how and why following Muhammad is a joke. You know, the Quran is a book of rabbi music, more than a book of teaching. But anyway, you know, let us see what Jesus said to us, and then we will see together what Muhammad said to the Muslims and how Islam is what Islam is about, specifically the prayer. When the Muslim he pray, what he wanted from his God. Now look what Jesus he said in here. Take, you know, you can read with me. Take your time and read, and you can read the chapter. You know, Jesus here saying, if you do something good, you know, be sure that you don't show off and you don't tell people you are doing good. As an example, if you want to make a donation, you don't go everywhere and say, I made a donation. If you feed the poor, you don't go and talk about it everywhere, etc. So he insists that, you know, those who do that, they are the hypocrite one. But the Muslims, they do exactly what Jesus is saying not to do. And I will show you why. One of the things people they do, especially the Muslims, is a prayer. Prayer or even donation. When they donate, they have to tell everybody. But when we speak about prayer specifically, Jesus, he said, if you pray, you know, go to your closet, go to your dark room where nobody can see you, and pray to your Father. Because if you don't, it's mean you are trying to show people that you are praying. Now somebody will say to me, then why you go to the church? Well, the church, it's, you know, we go mostly more than we just to pray. We go to learn from somebody who want to teach us about the Bible. It's a place where we group as a Christians, we meet. But the fact Jesus, he said, every two of you meet, I will be between them. In the same time, you can pray to the Lord even if you are alone. And actually, it's better if you are alone, so you can focus with your prayer. Unless you are trying to help somebody with the prayer, like, you know, Christians believe in the power of prayer, so they can meet as a group and they pray for somebody to help him. But if you want to speak to your Father, you speak to him directly. You do not need a middleman. We don't believe in middleman, and we don't believe that people should even see us praying. The Muslims, look what Jesus said about them. And when you prayest, shall not be as the hypocrite, are of their love to pray standing in the synagogues. This is what the Muslim, they stand so everybody can see them, and they pray in the corners of the street. Isn't it, this is exactly what the Muslims do? Did you see the Muslim who goes stand up in the top of his car in New York, so everybody going by is going to see him, you know, praying? Or Muslim praying in the middle of the street, so 10,000 will see and they will be wondering, what's wrong with those people? Like, so what if you want to pray? Why you are doing this? Because Muslims are people of hypocrisy. Those who pray in the street, in the corners, they get their reward from the people around them. So people, they will say, oh, they are good people, you know, like they are praying. This is the point of this prayer. This prayer is not meant to be a prayer. Same time, Jesus said, but you, he's speaking to who? To those who follow Christ, which means us. If you pray, you go inside your closet, inside your dark room, you know, and you pray and nobody see you. Speak to the Father, the one who see everything. You do not need to show yourself. He is there. And look what he said too. One of the things about Muslims, they love to repeat words. As an example, the chapter of Al-Fatiha, which we see in front of us. The Muslim, they have to recite this chapter 5 times a day. I want to ask the Muslims, what's the point of reciting the same words 5 times a day? And it's not even their own word. You know, somebody will say, oh, don't you Christians pray the Our Father Art of Heaven, the one you are showing us right now? Don't you pray it? Let me tell you, no, I don't have to pray it. When Jesus, he in here taught us how to pray, because they asked him how to pray. So he was showing them what is a Christian should ask for when he pray. But he did not ask us to pray that prayer. Don't be like those hypocrites. Don't be like those who repeat their words. Don't be like etc. But pray like this. Our Father out of heaven, praising the name of the Lord, accepting the will of the Lord, asking the Lord to provide us, asking for forgiveness for our sin, the same as we forgive to others. And this is very important, by the way. This is one of the beautiful things about Jesus Christ's teaching. Because you will notice in here, Jesus is asking us, we are requested in our prayer to provide ourselves to the Lord after forgiving our sin, which the sin of others, which means somebody, I'm not talking about my sin, I'm saying somebody, he made a sin against me. Let us say somebody, he insulted me. Somebody, he took my money. Somebody, he did something bad to me, speak about me, whatever. So we forgive that sin which made against us, because Jesus in here is teaching us, well, if you are not willing to forgive to others, why the Father will forgive for you? If you are so selfish to the point you don't want to forgive to others, why you are asking you yourself to be forgiven when you don't forgive? So one of the beautiful things about Christ, that he wants people to speak to the Father when there is nothing bad in their heart. They love everybody and they forgive everybody. And then you can pray to the Lord. You don't go pray to him and you hate everyone. You don't go pray to every, you know, pray to the Lord and you are a person who is full of hate and anger, etc. Take it out. Say, Lord, I forgive them. By the way, if I forgive somebody, let's say there's somebody who did something bad against me. If I forgive him, does not mean he's forgiven. The Lord is the Lord of justice. Don't worry about it. But you are doing something for yourself. You're not doing it even for him. Don't think that you are forgiving others because you are doing it for them. No, you are doing it for yourself. Because if you are asking the Lord, the Father, to forgive you, then you have to prove that you deserve it. I forgive to others, and I did, and I mean it. Now, what is left is going to be between him and the Lord. In the judgment day, he will judge the person who did bad. Don't worry. God is all about justice. But in the front of the Lord, you forgive him. Therefore, the Lord, he is going to give you forgiveness too, because you deserve it. You are a person who believes in forgiveness. As long as you believe in it, you forgive to others, you know, you deserve forgiveness. And that will make peace in society. You know, imagine if all people in the world, they forgive each other when they get angry. Imagine when if wives and husbands, just wife and husbands, they practice this. When I do something, you know, wrong to my wife, she forgive me. When she do something to me, I forgive her. Then we will not see divorce, and we will not see people fighting, and we will not see courts. We will not see, you know, people, they need help. And number one help is to get their hate out. Out by what? By forgiving, not by speaking it out. You enter into the stage of a prayer with the Lord after you forgive others for what did it to you. In the same time, if we look at the Muslim prayer, we will see this. First, you praise Allah. the most merciful, etc. And by the way, the one is talking here is Allah. He says in the name of Allah. Isn't it really funny? If you are Allah, why you are saying the name of Allah? That is additional proof that the one who made the Quran is this is not God speaking. Cannot be God. This is a third man party. He is saying, he's praising God. Praise be to Allah again. We praise him again. Because we just say the name of Allah, the beneficent and the merciful. Praise be to Allah. Allah saying praise be to Allah. Isn't it weird? The Lord of the world, thank you. The beneficent of the and merciful. Well, already we said beneficent and merciful. Now, do you see how stupid? It's repeating the words. Jesus, he said, don't repeat your words. Don't be like those hypocrites who keep repeating their words. You see it? Don't repeat your words. He just said that, you know, the most beneficent and the most merciful. In the same time, verse number 3, the beneficent, the merciful. So what's the point of this? It's just simply to repeat himself because he has nothing to say. The owner of the judgment day, okay, and alone we worship and alone we seek help. Just wait. Allah saying alone we worship, alone we seek. The one is talking is Allah. You know, if Allah said in the beginning, the verse says, pray like this, the same as Jesus said to them. If you read with me in here, Jesus said, and when you pray, you shall don't do this and this and this. But the verse in here doesn't say. This is God supposed to speaking directly. He's saying, in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most beneficent, merciful. Praise be to Allah, the Lord of the world, the beneficent, the merciful. Owner of the judgment day, thee alone we worship, and thee alone we seek help. Like God saying that? It cannot be God speaking. It must be a man making this verse. Show us the straight path. Until now we are fine. Even though, until now they said nothing. It's a stupid thing. Because the first verse is the same as the third verse. And the one who prays Allah anyway, you know, for sure he is praising him, and he don't worship anyone else. Because did he say we praise Allah and the other gods? Did he say we praise Allah and we praise Obama and we praise Hillary Clinton? He just said Allah, so he praised Allah, so Allah is the only God for him. But he continues saying, alone we worship, alone we seek. Show us the straight path, and look, bath those whom thou hast for a favored, not the bath of those who earn thine anger, nor of those who go astray. What they mean, by the way, in here, in this chapter, in this verse, they are speaking about the Christians. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Not like those who they are, you curse them. Not like those who they are, you know, you lead them astray. Imagine. We as a Christian, we say, we pray, oh God, don't make us like those who they are Muslims. But what is that? Isn't it stupid? Isn't it even disgusting? We as a Christian, we pray to everybody in the world. The Muslim, they don't pray for us, they pray against us. At the same time, they say, oh, don't make us like them, Allah, don't make us like them, please. Huh? Show us the straight path. The path of those whom those favored. So Allah in here is the one who showed the path of both. The path of the one who they are seeing the truth, and the path of those who lead astray. This is why they are asking him to show the true one, because he can show you the wrong one. Because Allah, remember, is the deceiver. We showed you many verses in the Quran saying that Allah, he lead people astray. So if we go to the Bible, we see the story is different. The prayer is deep. The prayer is real. Before you pray, you have to forgive others. When you pray, don't show off. When you pray, don't repeat the words. Muslims, they repeat this prayer 5 times a day, saying nothing except the same word of Allah. It's not even their own words. Where is your prayer? In the top of that, they pray to their God, speaking in a language which is not even their language. Because they pray in Arabic. A Pakistani guy, what he have to do with Arabic? An Indonesian guy, what he had to do with Arabic? So they recited the same as a recording machine, and they themselves, they have no idea what even the verse is saying.